At huwag mo kami pahintulot sa tukso, tiyadya mo kami sa lahat ng masama, amin. Ama namin, Aba Ginoong Marias, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoong Diyos ay sumasa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat at pinagpala rin naman ng iyong anak na Hesus.
Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kami makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen.
Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoong Diyos ay sumasa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat at pinagpala rin naman ng iyong anak na Hesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kaming makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen. Aba Ginoong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoong Diyos ay sumasa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat at pinagpala rin naman ang iyong anak na Hesus.
Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kami makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen.
Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya.
Ang Panginoong Diyos ay sumasa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kami makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen. Ubang kasay at
pinagpala sa lahat at pinagpala rin naman ang iyong anak na Hesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kaming makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen. Aba Ginoong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoong Diyos ay sumasa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat at pinagpala rin naman ang iyong anak na Hesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kaming makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen. Aba Ginoong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoong Diyos ay sumasa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat at pinagpala naman ang iyong anak na Hesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kaming makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen. Aba Ginoong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoong Diyos ay sumasa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat at pinagpala naman ang iyong anak na Hesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kaming makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen. Aba Ginoong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoong Diyos ay sumasa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat at pinagpala naman ang iyong anak na Hesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kaming makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen. Aba Ginoong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoong Diyos ay sumasa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat at pinagpala naman ang iyong anak na Hesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kaming makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamamatay. Amen. Luwalhati sa Ama, sa Anak, at sa Espiritu Santo, kaparan ng unang-una, ngayon magpakailanman, magpasawalang hanggan. Amen. O Jesus ko, patawarin mo ang aming mga sala. Iligtas mo kami sa apoy na impyerno. Hanguin mo ang mga kaluluwa sa purgatorio, lalong-lalo na yaong walang nakaalaala. Aba po, Santa Maria ang Reyna, Ina ng Awa, Aba ng aming buhay, katamisan at pag-asa. Sa iyo kami nananawagan, kaming itinaboy ng mga anal ni Eva. Sa iyo ipinararating namin ang aming mga himutok, dalamhati at pagluha sa lupang iyong hapis-hapis. Ibaling mo sa aming magiliw na tagalilig ang iyong mga matangmawain. At kung matapos yaring buhay, ipakilala sa amin ang iyong anak na Hesus, umawain, mapagmahal at matamis na berhen. Manalangin tayo, O Diyos na pagkaisa-isa mong anak sa pamamagitan ng kanyang buhay, pagkamatay at pagkabuhay ng muli, at ipinagtamo sa amin ng gantimpalang buhay na walang hanggan, ipagkaloob mo isinasamo namin sa pagninilay na ito ang mga misteryo ng kabanal-banalang rosaryo ng pinagpalang Berheng Maria. Matularan nawa namin ang kanilang nilalaman at kantan namin ang kanyang pinangako alang-alang kay Kristong aming Panginoon. Amen. Sa ngalan ng Ama, ng Anak, at ng Espiritu Santo. Amen.
We will now proceed to the devotion to the Sorrowful Mother. Please stand.
Stabat, Mater Dei. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, we accompany the Blessed Virgin Mary in her sorrow as we meditate her sorrows, especially the death of her son. As we accompany her, may we learn also from her and her virtues in this moment of grief.
The first sorrow, the prophecy of Simeon. Please kneel. This child is destined to be the downfall and the rise of many in Israel, a sign that will be opposed.
And you yourself shall be pierced with sword, so that the thoughts of many hearts may be laid bare.
Mother of sorrows, we call to mind the sword of grief that pierced you upon hearing the prophetic words of Simeon concerning Jesus, your son.
We fervently beg you to win a new outpouring of grace for all mankind, to listen to the message of your son, lest he be a sign of condemnation instead of salvation. For there is no other name in the whole world given to men by which we are to be saved.
Let us pray. We grieve for you, O Mary, most sorrowful, in the affliction of your tender heart, at the prophecy of the holy and aged Simeon. Dear Mother, by your heart so afflicted, obtain for us the virtue of humility and the gift of the holy fear of God.
Amen. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen.
The second sorrow, the flight into Egypt. Get up, take the child and his mother, and flee to Egypt. Herod is searching for the child to destroy him.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes.
Mother of sorrows, we call to mind the sword of grief that pierced you when you fled into foreign land with your beloved child, whose life was sought even when he was a tender child.
We beg you, take under your powerful protection all Christians, that they may escape the snares of the evil one, to destroy the Christ life within them, and help them arrive safely in their heavenly home.
We pray. We grieve for you, O Mary, most sorrowful, in the anguish of your most affectionate heart during the flight into Egypt and your sojourn there. Dear Mother, by your heart so troubled, obtain for us the virtue of generosity, especially toward the poor, and the gift of piety.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The third sorrow, the 3 days loss of the child Jesus. I will rise and go about the city. In the streets and the crossings, I will seek him whose heart my heart loves.
Son, why have you done this to us? You see that your father and I have been searching for you in sorrow.
Mother of sorrows, we call to mind the sword which pierced you when you sought your divine son for 3 days in anxiety and grief.
We beg you to obtain for all those who are truly searching for Christ joy and peace, finding that Jesus of the Gospels is the answer to their searching. Obtain also for many pagans who have not as yet had the good news preached to them, the grace of faith in Jesus, the Savior of the world.
We grieve for you, O Mary, most sorrowful, in those anxieties which tried your troubled heart at the loss of your dear Jesus. Dear Mother, by your heart so full of anguish, obtain for us the virtue of chastity and the gift of knowledge.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The fourth sorrow. Mary meets Jesus carrying his cross. There was in him no stately bearing to make us look at him, nor appearance that would attract us to him. Spurned and avoided by men, a man of suffering, accustomed to infirmity.
Do not call me Naomi, call me Mara, for the Almighty has made it very bitter for me.
Mother of sorrows, we call to mind the sword of grief which pierced you when you beheld your son bound like a criminal, covered with shame, and bowed down under the heavy burden of the cross on the way to Golgotha.
We beg you to obtain from God renewed courage for all those who are heavily laden with trials of any kind, that they bear their cross without complaint and faithfully follow in the footsteps of the Savior in loving patience.
Continually we care about in our bodies the dying of Jesus, so that in our bodies the life of Jesus may also be revealed.
We will be heirs with Christ only if we suffer with him, so as to be glorified with him.
We grieve for you, O Mary, most sorrowful, in the consternation of your heart at meeting Jesus as he carried his cross. Dear Mother, by your heart so troubled, obtain for us the virtue of patience and the gift of fortitude.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Please stand.
Maria, Mater Dum Fidelma, Nati Penas Inclini, Nati Penas Inclini, Christus Domo qui non flere,
fifth sorrow, Mary at the foot of the cross. Kindly kneel. They shall look at him whom they have thrust through, and they shall mourn for him as one mourns for an only son.
Jesus said to his mother, Woman, there is your son. In turn, he said to the disciple, There is your mother.
Mother of sorrows, we call to mind the sword of sorrow that pierced you as you stood at the foot of the cross, fully sharing the suffering and death agony of your son, and offering him in the name of all to do the Heavenly Father.
We beg you to obtain for all who turn to you in sincere compassion the grace of conversion from sinful ways, in genuine renewal in the Spirit, which Jesus won by his passion and death.
We grieve for you, O Mary, most sorrowful, in the martyrdom which your generous heart endured in standing near Jesus in his agony. Dear Mother, by your afflicted heart obtain for us the virtue of temperance and the gift of counsel.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The sixth sorrow, the body of Jesus is placed in Mary's arms. To what can I liken or compare you, O daughter Jerusalem? What example can I show you for your comfort, Virgin Daughter Zion?
Come, all you who pass by the way, look and see whether there is any suffering like my suffering, which has been dealt me when the Lord afflicted me.
Mother of sorrows, we call to mind the sorrow of grief which pierced you when the body of Jesus was laid in your arms after it was taken down from the cross.
Assist the dying in their last struggle, and win for us the grace of final perseverance through the merits of the salvific death of your divine Son and your own loving compassion.
We grieve for you, O Mary, most sorrowful, in the wounding of your compassionate heart, when the side of Jesus was struck by the lance before his body was removed from the cross. Dear Mother, by your heart thus transfixed, obtain for us the virtue of fraternal charity and the gift of understanding.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The seventh sorrow, the body of Jesus is laid in the tomb. The Lord has left me desolate, in pain all the day.
At this I weep, my eyes run with tears. Far from me are all who could console me.
Mother of sorrows, we call to mind the sorrow of grief which pierced you when Jesus, your beloved Son, your life and your love, was laid in the tomb.
Keep alive in our hearts the hope of the resurrection, and intercede for all the faithful departed who were nourished on the bread of life, a speedy admission to the vision of God. There we hope to join the company of the saints and live forever with you and your divine Son in the mansions of the Father.
We grieve for you, Mary, most sorrowful, for the pangs that rent your most loving heart at the burial of Jesus. Dear Mother, by your heart sunk in bitterness of desolation, obtain for us the virtue of diligence and the gift of wisdom.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Please stand. Be seated.
Some pointers for our reflection in this devotion to the Sorrowful Mother. In the scene we find in the Gospel of John, which we heard in the Gospel, we encounter a profound moment of anguish and resilience expressed in the figure of Mary, the mother of Jesus, standing at the foot of the cross, in a scene that invites us into the depths of human suffering, maternal love, and unwavering faith. And Mary stood there, witnessing her son's agony, her heart undoubtedly shattered into a million pieces. She, who had cradled the infant Jesus in her arms, now beheld him crucified before her eyes. The sword of sorrow, prophesied by Simeon, pierced her soul with the magnitude beyond comprehension. Yet in the midst of her profound grief, Mary's presence at the foot of the cross speaks volumes about her strength and her faith. In Mary's sorrow, we find a profound connection to the sorrows also of our lives. We can relate to the anguish of witnessing the ones we love suffer, the agony of feeling powerless in the face of injustices, and the crushing weight of loss and betrayal, especially of significant people in our lives. Mary stands as a beacon of solidarity for all who endure suffering, reminding us that even in our darkest moments, we are not alone. But Mary's presence at the foot of the cross also offers us a profound example of faith and surrender. Despite the overwhelming pain, she did not flee from the scene. Instead, she stood firm, embracing the will of God with an unwavering trust. In her silent vigil, Mary teaches us the importance of staying grounded in our faith, even when the storms of life rage around us. Moreover, Mary's sorrows are not merely a cause for despair. They are also a source of hope for us. For in the mystery of the cross, we discover the transformative power of love and redemption. Through Jesus' sacrifice, Mary's sorrows are transformed into instruments of salvation for all humanity. Her pain becomes a pathway to grace, inviting us to unite our own sufferings with those of Christ for the redemption of the world. As we reflect on the scene and the sorrows of Mary, let us draw strength from her example of faith, courage, and perseverance. Let us entrust our own sorrows in her loving hands, knowing that she walks with us in our struggles and intercedes for us before the throne of God. Let us never lose sight of that profound truth that through the cross, our sorrows can be transformed into sources of grace and hope, leading us ever closer to the eternal joy of God's kingdom. And may our contemplation of the Sorrowful Mother and the Santo Entierro help us to grow in our hope beyond our own suffering and pain. Amen.
Please stand.
Let us now gather our prayers and praises into one, and let us offer the prayer Christ Himself taught us. Let us pray. O God, who willed that when your Son was lifted high on the cross, his mother should stand close by and share his suffering, grant that your Church, participating with the Virgin Mary in the Passion of Christ, may merit a share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord and give Him thanks.
Thank you.
Amen.